to argue with Moses. Why did you bring us out of Egypt? Are you trying to kill us, our children, and our livestock with thirst? Then Moses cried out to the Lord, what should I do with these people? They are ready to stone me. The Lord said to Moses, walk out in front of the people. Take your staff, the one you used when you struck the water of the Nile, and call some of the elders of Israel to join you. I will stand before you on the rock at Mount Sinai. Strike the rock, and water will come gushing out. Then the people will be able to drink. So Moses struck the rock as he was told, and water gushed as the elders looked on. Moses named the place Massa, which means test, and Meribah, which means arguing, because the people of Israel with Moses, Moses argued and tested the Lord by saying, is the Lord here with us or not? Israel defeats the Amalekites. While the people of Israel were still at Rephidim, the warriors of Amalek attacked them. Moses commanded Joshua, choose some men to go out and fight the army of Amalek for us. Tomorrow I'll stand at the top of the hill holding the staff of God in my hand. So Joshua did what Moses had commanded and fought the army of Amalek. Meanwhile, Moses, Aaron, and Hur climbed to the top of the nearby hill. As long as Moses held up the staff in his hand, the Israelites had the advantage. But whenever he dropped his hand, the Amalekites gained the advantage. Moses' arm soon became so tired he could no longer hold them up. So Aaron and Hur found a stone for him to sit on. Then they stood on each side of Moses, holding up his hand, so his hand held steady until sunset. As a result, Joshua overwhelmed the army of Amalek in battle. Okay, I'm going to pray real fast. Dear Jesus, I pray right now that you would just anoint every word that comes from my mouth, Lord God, that your anointing would be in this place, that we would get everything that you have for us, God. I pray right now that we would just have such open hearts for what you have, Lord Jesus, and just be in this place. And thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay. So we're going to be talking about a battle that you're going through. And in these verses, my first point is I can do it myself. How many of you like to do things yourself? I do. I really, really do. I really like to do things myself. Matthew gets on to me all the time because I take on all these things. Like, I do a lot. And he gets on to me because he's like, why do you do that? You need to delegate. And I have this thing where I can trust myself, and I know I'm going to show up, and I know I'm going to do it. And so I trust myself, and I do it myself. And a lot of us do that in life. A lot of us think, you know what, I'm going to go through life, I'm going to go through the battle, and I'm going to do it by myself because I can trust myself. Because a lot of times we've been failed by other people. And so, in this story, the Israelites, they were actually in slavery. They were enslaved for a long time. They were forced to do heavy labor. It wasn't like anything fun. And they got saved. Okay, so Moses came in and saved them, and they walked across a sea where God had split it, and they walked between two walls of water. See? Yeah. So they walked between two walls of water. They saw this miraculous thing. How many of you guys have walked through two walls of water? God split the water? No. Nobody. So they saw all this miraculous stuff, and then they said to Moses, they said, why did you even save us? Why did you even do that? After they've seen all these miracles, they saw how God sent all these plagues so that they could be free, and they said, why did you even do that? They didn't even trust. They didn't even believe. This was a bad battle. This guy thought that he could do it by Because we're totally unqualified to fight by ourselves. We're totally unqualified to go through the spiritual warfare that happens in our lives by ourselves. My next point is the enemy will use and attack every area of our life. The enemy will use and attack every area of our life. So in our Bible story from Moses, the Israelites, they've seen all these crazy things happen that God did. Just really big thing. And then they get out and there's no water. There's absolutely no water. And that seems like such a small thing, like, hey, there's no water, maybe it'll rain, you know, something like that. But they were like, I'm gonna go back. I wanna go back to slavery. They wanted to throw in the towel and go back to where they spent years upon years in slavery. And they said, I wanna give it all up. And that's what the enemy does. He attacks. He takes a little thing like the water away. And here's some things that the enemy uses and that the enemy attacks. Satan, and I know that this is like so totally unpopular and you've heard it 100 times, but Satan uses your music. He uses your music. He uses your music to get into your life. He uses your music to win that battle. And you say, how does he do that? I don't know if you know this, but there's music artists out there that you probably listen to that are actually, what they are Satan worshipers. Like, they do that. And when they're playing their music, when they're singing their music, they're actually putting that into the lyrics. Somebody told me the other day, there's a very popular music artist, and she actually rips up the Bible and does really gross things with it in her music video. No, I don't know. I didn't watch the video. Anyway, so Satan uses our music, and I'm not saying every secular artist is bad. I'm not saying every secular song is bad, but I'm saying when you're choosing the music that you're listening to, you need to look at the lyrics. You need to look at the artist, because that makes a difference. Another one is, I have a scary movie up there. I have a scary movie up there, and you think, what's so wrong about a scary movie? How is Satan going to get to me through a scary movie? Well, no, I'm going to tell you, there's demons. They're using demonic things in the movies. I can remember when I was in high school, we actually had a guy in our church, and I think he was sitting in his chair. I don't think he came to the altar. I think he was sitting in his chair, and he wanted someone to come and pray with him. And we began to pray with him. And something that happens when the devil can consume your life, when he can get into your life, he can take over. And he actually had a demon inside of him. And as we were praying and denouncing the devil, you know, and saying in the name of Jesus, because when you say Jesus' name, the demons will flee. A devil actually left his body, and the only thing that he could think of was that he was really consumed with scary movies. And you think, that's so crazy, but I'm telling you, there's a spiritual warfare going on, and there's little things that you don't even realize where the enemy can get into your life, and he can take, and he's taking over, and just like the very unqualified man, that's what happens to us as we become unqualified to fight, because the devil begins to take over. And he'll attack things. He'll attack things in our life. He'll attack our friends. He'll attack our family. We feel like everybody's against us. We feel like we're in an impossible situation. We feel like we're losing the battle. But I'm here to tell you tonight that the battle's already been won. The battle's already been won. And the only way to win that battle is Jesus. The only way is to listen and to call out to Jesus and say, you know what? I can't do it by myself. I can't do it by myself. And you know what? That's really hard for me. Sometimes it's really hard for me to admit to God and say, God, I can't do it by myself. I can't do my everyday life by myself, and I need you. Because I am a person that just wants to do it myself. I want to do it myself. And I'm so unqualified. I'm so unqualified to do it myself. In our story, Moses, he held his hands up because God told him, if you hold your hands up, you'll win the battle. If you hold your hands up, you'll win the battle. And they won. They won. But what happened when Moses' hands got tired? What happened? God sent people to him to help him through the battle.